So after preparing a table, we have cast a chart according to given data by native. So I have already rectified the chart. So on that chart, NM
means natal moon. Natal moon 2S 28 degrees to 32 minutes 40 seconds. 2S means Gemini. So in that natal chart, moon is Gemini sign. So NM means natal moon, this degrees. NA means natal ascendant, this degrees. PNEA, prenatal epoch ascendant. PNEA means prenatal epoch ascendant. Here, when date of birth is given by native, from that date of birth, 9 months should be subtracted. Then we get prenatal epoch date. So I will explain how can we get that prenatal epoch date first. So on that date, PNEA, not date of birth ascendant, prenatal epoch ascendant. So prenatal epoch ascendant, this degrees. Here, before to find prenatal epoch date, we have a small calculation. That is, here AR means ascendant remainder. AR means ascendant remainder. How can we get? So here ascendant from 30 degrees, this degree should be subtracted. Then we get AR. Okay? From 30 degrees, this degree should be subtracted. We have to subtract this degrees from 30 degrees. Then we get AR, ascendant remainder. Like that, MR. MR means moon remainder. From 30 degrees, moon degrees should be subtracted. Then we get MR. So here, AR this degrees, MR this degrees. These two degrees should be added. These 2 degrees should be added and multiplied by this number, 0.98564. These two numbers should be added. From the total amount, this number should be multiplied. And finally, this number should be added. That means 0.98564 should multiplied. And finally, 238.573 number should be added. So total, final we can get 263.337 days. This is called intrauterine life. Intrauterine life. This is called IUL. IUL means the period of pregnancy, the time of pregnancy, duration of pregnancy, you can say. So AR and MR should be added. How can we get AR and MR? From 30 degrees, these degrees should be added, should be subtracted. Then we can get AR and MR. Then addition and multiplication and finally addition. Total we can get this number. This number, that these days are called intrauterine life, IULs in simplified form. So you can say another words, duration of pregnancy. Now PNEA date. PNEA date, period of birth time minus IUL. Period of birth time minus IUL. In equation 1, we noticed that period of time birth is equal to 247.040 minus IUL 263.337. So surplus is there 16.297. Now, this is the date of birth given by native, 1991 September 9. 9 months subtracted, then December 1995. So, 5th here, 5th is not considered. From date of birth, 9 months should be subtracted, but date is not considered. Now, how can you get PNE date? Now, listen to me. Here, PNE date is equal to period of birth time minus IUL. How much you can get? 16.297. Here 16.297 means 17th. That means 16 point means after 16. That means after 16 means 17th. So here 17th death should come. That means 17, 12, 1990. This is the prenatal epoch date. This is the prenatal epoch date. Suppose for example here are 10 point something,
then 10 point means 11 you should take. Like that 16 point, that means 17. So 1919 December 17 is prenatal epoch date. So date of birth this, prenatal epoch date this. Okay? So finally, we can get prenatal epoch date and prenatal epoch birth time. 21 hours, 23 minutes, 49 seconds. Now, you will get a doubt. What is that? So how can you believe that this is the time of prenatal epoch date? So we can believe, you can prove, how you can tell me how can you get prenatal epoch date. But this is the, how can we believe you that this is the correct? Okay, so I will clarify your doubt. So there are three formulas to verify, to correct whether we did prenatal epoch date right or wrong. So I will tell you one of the formula. The formula is distance natal moon to natal ascendant is equal to natal moon to prenatal epoch ascendant. That means the distance between natal moon and natal ascendant is equal to that distance between natal moon to PNEA. Here, for example, in this figure, here is NM, natal moon. Here is PNEA, prenatal epoch ascendant. Here, natal ascendant. Suppose, for example, the distance between these two points, that is not NM to NEA. Suppose, for example, let us say, 80 degrees. The distance between the two points is 80 degrees. Here also, the distance between natal moon to PNEA, also 80 degrees. So, here 80 degrees is equal to here 80 degrees. That means, suppose here, the distance between these two points is 8 degrees. Then here also, the distance between NM to PNEA is 8 degrees. Then both are equal. That means, we can say once again, the distance between the two points, NEA to NM, is equal to the distance between natal moon to PNEA. When these formulas satisfied, we can say boldly our prenatal epoch date and time, which is we have did, is correct, 100% correct. When this formula is satisfied only. Okay? Now, here, NM is this degrees, NEA is this degrees. So, the distance is this. Equation 3. We can say equation 3. And PNEA is equal to this degrees. And NM is equal to this degrees. Distance is degrees. This is a fourth equation. So, here you can examine here. Equation 3 is equal to equation 4. Actually, 0 is 22, 13, 3 minutes, seconds. 0 is 22 degrees, 13 minutes, 3 seconds. So here, 3 and 4 are equal. That means distance between NM to NEA and distance between PNEA to NM. Here, this formula is 100% satisfied. This formula is satisfied. So we can say broadly, our PNEA date and PNEA time, which is gotten by us, is 100% right. So, next step, events should be satisfied, events should be verified. So in my next video, I will explain you how events are verified. Okay, thank you.